Seriously, how is nobody talking about this yet? This is a major, major problem. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, what I like to do is take a look at the YouTube community, all the drama that's going on, and take this mess and turn it into a message. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. So the YouTube algorithm, it's been doing its thing for me. It knows I've been making videos about James Charles, keeping up to date, all these things. And all of a sudden I get recommended a video that says, my experience dating James Charles. I'm like, oh no, James, how many straight guys are gonna come out of the woodwork to accuse you? And then I look at the thumbnail, I'm like, this dude looks familiar. This dude looks really familiar. And I know why he looks familiar, because back in 2018, he was doing this.
Normally, I wouldn't wanna blast this. You know, you do you, there's a bunch of shit on YouTube that I wouldn't wanna see, but I see this thumbnail, and so it starts here, right? One kill equals remove one clothing with my 13-year-old sister. And now he got the thumbnail with the, oh God, is that me? Yeah, dude.
All right, like real talk, all of you need to go down to the description below and watch that entire video. It is from Sky Williams. I wish that dude made more content. But anyways, that's from Sky Williams. It discusses the whole situation. But last year, everybody was making videos on this guy. So I'll circle back to that in a second. But anyways, this dude, what's his name? Carmi, and I think his YouTube channel is like Touch Delight. This video he made accusing James Charles has over 400,000 views, and it is the most disgusting thing I have ever seen on this platform. Well, there's some terrible stuff that's happened on this platform, but you guys, like, so this dude, Carmi, his whole story is this, is that James Charles talked to him at VidCon while he was drunk, asked him what his Twitter and Instagram name was, and apparently now that's predatory behavior, all right? That's predatory behavior. But anyways, James Charles asked this guy if he was gay. And the guy's like, I'm not gay. And James Charles's like, oh, thought you were gay. All right, that's pretty much the extent of this story. And this dude is coming out like he's a victim of the situation. Like, I honestly thought that this was going to turn into another one of the other stories, like with Gage or the waiter from Seattle, where it was like, you know, they consented to hooking up with James Charles. It's not even that. It's not even that. And this dude is talking about his experience dating James Charles, and he's blowing this situation up like James was like pushy with him or trying to force him into something like so many people are accusing him of right now. And like I said, this is an issue because this video has over 400,000 views, and it blows my mind that nobody's talking about this. Like, this is disgusting because right now we are in such a crappy situation, all right? Like, as many of you know, I'm a mental health advocate. I worked in an addiction treatment center for a little over 3 years. I cannot tell you how many people, both men and women, both straight, gay, lesbian, whatever they identified with, I cannot tell you how many victims came through my treatment center. And for many people, like, sexual assault is the catalyst for addiction. And that's a whole nother video about why I hate how people demonize addicts. Like people just woke up one day, it's like, oh, I'm gonna smoke some meth or shoot some heroin. No, people had traumatic experiences. And with so many people accusing James Charles, like, this is a very delicate subject, all right? Very delicate subject. Like, one of the reasons why I'm making videos in defense of James Charles is because the most harmful accusations of James Charles have been debunked, all right? When it comes to Gage and the Seattle waiter, I think that those were just messy situations. I don't believe that James Charles you know, from the evidence that we have that he tried to push anybody or anything like that, like, they consented to it, they found out, they're like, hey, you know what, I guess I'm straight. James Charles got his feelings hurt, you know what, stuff like that happens. But for this dude, Carmi, to make an entire video saying this and accusing James, and like, he says like at the end of the video, like, I felt like I needed to make this, I felt like I needed to make this, like, the hell you did, bro. Like, with so many accusations and the fire that James Charles is under right now, to come out with this, like, apparently it's illegal for a gay man to even flirt with a straight man. Okay, so one of my best friends lives in Long Beach, okay? In Long Beach, she lives in a neighborhood called, or what they refer to as the gayborhood, okay? It is an LGBT like neighborhood. It's awesome, it's fun, I love it. But anyways, I'm a straight man, and not far from her house is a coffee shop that is owned. It is ran by the LGBTQ community. To my knowledge, every time I've went there, all of the employees are either identify as gay or lesbian or something in the LGBTQ, right? And I've gone there and I feel nice. I feel nice going in there as a straight man because sometimes they'll flirt with me. I say, no thank you, you know what I mean? But I guess I'm a bear and some people are into that stuff. But they compliment me and things like that. Maybe I don't know, maybe my head's just getting big and they just compliment me because I got an amazing sense of fashion. But anyways, like, are they being predators? Like, are they being predators? Like, this has gone so far out of control. And here's the thing too, like, he's talking about how he was awkward and uncomfortable that James Charles asked him if he was gay. Do you know how many people have asked me if I was gay in my comment section? Just because, I don't know I come off a little sassy and things like that. I think that's my half black side coming out. But anyways, like I've had people ask me that in the comment section. Are those people predators? Should I make videos accusing everybody in the comment section who has ever asked me if I'm gay? Like, are you serious right now? But coming back to who this guy is making this, like, again, this is so difficult to talk about because I've already seen this happening on Twitter where people have shown and proven that people are lying about James Charles, and then people are coming out and saying, oh my God, I can't believe you're calling a victim a liar. And it is such a delicate subject that really, that is so difficult and touchy to even like have a conversation around. Like when the Brett Kavanaugh situation was happening, I made a video about that and believing survivors and, you know, the trauma that Dr. Christine Blasey Ford went through and everything like that. And the reality is like, the people like this guy Carmi who are accusing him, like, it's almost a jerk move to even say like, oh no, that didn't happen. But the only reason I'm making this video is because by his own account, him and James Charles never had any physical contact at all. He talks in one portion about like, oh, I didn't want to go out to LA and hang out with James Charles because I don't know what I would have done. What, is it James Charles' fault that you might hook up with him because you might be attracted to him, because you might be a little bit curious, like you admitted in this damn video? So this dude, for those of you who don't know, again, check out the Sky Williams video, but last year, it was all over the YouTube community and all of the commentary channels. I can't remember if I made a video on this, but this dude was clickbaiting kids into videos about like incest and pedophilia. Like he was talking about like, cause there was all these Fortnite challenges going on. He was making videos like, oh, every kill my 13-year-old sister has to take her clothes off. Like what? And now this dude has the cojones to come onto YouTube and accuse James Charles of this behavior while this dude is under so much fire. And here's the other thing too. He said like check his Instagram for like the receipts. He provided one screenshot. It was James Charles saying he's cute. Again, it is not illegal for a gay man to say that you look attractive. Hell, if any of you out there think that I'm attractive, let me know. It makes me feel good about myself. But anyways, he had no other receipts. He said go check his Instagram, but the only thing I saw on his Instagram was this from the story, was a brief summary of James Charles messaging him, telling him to take that video down. And you are damn right he should. Like, you guys, please pay attention to what's going on. Like, cancel culture and the mob mentality is absolutely out of control. And I appreciate people like I'm Alex and others who are calling out the people faking these stories, because every time somebody fakes a story of abuse, assault, or anything like that, it makes it that much harder for real victims to come out and share their experience, because their stories and their experience, their trauma, is being diluted by jackholes like this, all right? So if anybody else in the commentary community, any drama channels, see this, please make a video about this, because this dude, Carmi, is a disgusting human being. But that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell, because I make a ton of videos. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And if you would like to support what I am doing here and get involved in our monthly Q&A, get your name in the credits right here. Click or tap right there on that Patreon icon, all right? Thanks again so, so much for watching. I'll see you next time.